like there was in the late 60s in San Francisco. It's a phenomenon that will never happen again. Stay love and trust now. You gotta wear a condom. Make sure you wear a condom. It's a life and death situation. It'll never be the same. Just make sure you stay alive.
Songs. Yeah. deep. We'll be right back.
too hard tonight. They keep breaking. That's why we're clubbing for them. I bet you didn't even know that. So pick another sing-along. What do you want? Thank you. Exxon was kidnapped, right? Yeah. President of Exxon was kidnapped. They're holding him for ransom, I believe. I just know it was somebody from San Francisco, and I have to applaud. And so to that person, I say one, two, three, four.
What the fuck is this world? What are you doing again? Leave a message, please die. Don't let your voice for the last time. Gave me my freedom, let's go. Give my time, I will.
thank you very much for coming out tonight. Sorry we were kind of late.
Bands. And this is a new song called Drop the Leash, get out of my fucking face. Tomorrow, San Francisco. We don't forget this place.
Home when former members of Seattle's Temple of the Dog appeared with their better-known current bands, Soundgarden and Pearl Jam. Each band is wrapping up their individual road plans in preparation for joining this summer's Lollapalooza tour. Pearl Jam, who have been on the road non-stop for the last year, are planning a free concert for their hometown fans in Seattle.
It's kind of our warm-up for Lollapalooza. It's going to be at Gasworks Park, and we really don't know, like, you know, what sort of a turnout we're going to have, but we didn't want to just go back and just play, like, you know, a couple of theater shows or whatever. We wanted to kind of make a special show back in Seattle.
Soundgarden has been touring extensively as well. They did manage to get a little studio time recently to record some pet cover tunes of songs by Devo, Black Sabbath, and the Rolling Stones. An EP featuring the results will be included at no cost in special copies of the album Bad Motor Finger, available in late June.
What it is a collection of B-sides that we did. Like, we just went into a studio one day and recorded them all in a few minutes, 5 minutes or something, I don't know, however long it took to play them. It turned out pretty good, so we ended up deciding to release, like, say, 40 or 50,000 copies of our record with those songs as well.
The cover of Black Sabbath's Into the Void features new lyrics with an environmental message. That's new for Soundgarden, who will find themselves in heavy message territory during Lollapalooza.
I think it's good that somebody is offering it. You know, it's okay that somebody's out, that somebody's doing it, because, you know, nobody else really is. But in my opinion, you know, I'm a musician and we're a band, and we just, you know, we're there to entertain people. And if there's other things going on peripherally, then that's cool.
Houston fans may have caught Pearl Jam and Soundgarden at the end of their tours, but far from getting road-weary performances, the show was an all-night affair, culminating with both bands joining together to pound out Neil Young's anti-conservative anthem, Keep On Rockin' in the Free World.
Back in Los Angeles, we ran into former Jane's Addiction frontman Perry Farrell, the driving force behind the Lollapalooza tours, and the leader...